a very informal gathering to celebrate and commemorate Asim Bhatt and what he meant to all of us. People who emailed in to say that they'd like to say a few words. And so we have some names, and then after that, if there's anyone else who'd like to say something, just please come up and say a few words. Sabina, would you like to come up?
And we are.
I'm going to attempt to use words to express some semblance of my gratitude that my life was touched by Asim. Asim and I are related. Technically, I'm his niece. But we grew up like cousins and went to the same school. So, Abid aur Asim ke saath bachpan guzra. My mother has sent some pictures from Canada and asked me to read something on her behalf. So I'm going to read what my mother sent, and I quote, "Sounds of children echo through me, running, squealing, playing. They are all mine. Most of my memories of Asim are from his childhood, when the kids played together, had fun, crazy times. My fondest memory is of the time he entertained us with his spontaneous singing and role-playing. What you cannot see is his frenzied dance that followed. Most of it was horizontal. Sorry for not having a picture of it, because we were all rolling on the floor laughing, including the lead dancer, singer, drummer Asim and his band members. By the end, we begged him to stop. He did, only to take a breath and begin again. I wish he would dance back into life the same way. Take a breath and begin again." End quote. तो घर में तो ये हाल था, लेकिन स्कूल में एक दौर आया जब लड़के लड़कियां एक दूसरे से बात नहीं करते थे. So the rule was boys hate girls and girls hate boys. So Abid, wherever he is, followed this rule. But Asim, as we all know, was not one for girls. And this was very fortunate for his painfully shy and awkward niece. Because to me, lunch break meant finding a corner to eat my cheese sandwich by myself. I didn't have friends, but I had Asim. He would eat lunch with me, chatting happily, holding my hand, oblivious to an unending taunts and jeers from classmates. A gift from Asim. Our worlds parted, we grew into ourselves and reconnected as adults. I was delighted to see who he'd become, and thrilled that we had evolved separately to inhabit the same world of art and activism. And I was so proud of him. I was energized by our communications and excited to come back to Pakistan, get to know him better, work with him, change the world with him. On Friday, I asked, "What could I have done for you, Asim?" Today, I ask, "What can I do for you, Asim?" Because the things that pained you, quite honestly, the world can do without. And if I keep asking myself this question, "What can I do for you, Asim?" I believe it will make me a better person. Another gift from Asim. You were too full, Asim. Just too full. So you burst like a seed pod and scattered all that was inside you among all of us. This I humbly accept as your final parting gift. I came to change the world with you, and I stand in my commitment in the face of your physical absence. You will always be alive in my heart.
the whole picture.